Kia ora, this program is brought to you by Wellington Access Radio. Wellington Access Radio, make your voice heard.
Hello and welcome along to the Capital Blues Roots and Boogie Show on Wellington Access Radio, 783 AM on your radio and podcast all over the internet. I'm Del Thomas, and for the next 30 minutes I'll be bringing you some of the very best in local, national and international blues, roots and boogie music, starting off with this track from the wonderful Low Folsom. There for you, and Reconsider Baby. And coming up now is a track, a world exclusive in fact, of a couple of tracks from the Wellington Heads brand new album. The album's called Southern Night Skies, and we're going to have an interview with three of the members of the band after this, but in the meantime this track is called If I'm That Bad.
My baby said what I'm doing is wrong. Well, it can't be right when I'm singing this song. She make me feel so bad. Yes, I feel so bad. tell me that I'm out of control. Well, how can that be when I got so much soul? She made me feel so bad. Yes, I feel so bad. But if I'm that bad, how come I look this good? Got a fez that day, gotta get out of bed and gonna earn my pay. Well, she may be right, I may be wrong, but she sure gonna miss me when I'm gone. You know I feel so bad. She make me feel so bad. Honey, I love you. Gotta face that day, gotta get out of bed and gonna earn my pay. Well, she may be right, I may be wrong, but she sure gonna miss me when I'm gone. You know I feel so bad. She make me feel so bad.
Well, here we are at Bill Wood's little home studio in downtown Island Bay. Took me 3 hours to get here, but we got here nonetheless. And we're interviewing Wellington Heads, who are about to release a new album coming out in the next 2 weeks or so. So, the three guys that are here, say hello to the world on Access Radio.
Hello, Neil Warboys.
G'day, Jeff Keith, bass playing, man of the band here.
Hello, world.
And that's Bill Wood in the corner, doing his Spike Milligan impersonation, I think, possibly. So, right, we just want to do a wee bit of a history, a very brief potted history of what the Heads have been doing and how long you've been going. For people that don't know, you've been a bit of a Wellington institution. Been going as long as I've been in Wellington anyway, I think. But tell us a bit about yourselves.
Well, we did. We Wellington Heads started in 1995, and in this house, in fact, upstairs in the living room. That's why the first album was called Songs from the Living Room. And we had a burst of originality and wrote heaps and heaps of songs, which was just a lot of fun, you know. And that's how the band first started.
And is that album still available?
That album is still available. And I guess it was the chemistry that we, you know, suddenly realised we had between the three of us that has kept us going all these years and has arrived. We've arrived at album number
five.
Number five. So that's pretty exciting, and to be keeping on writing songs together has really been a great pleasure.
And we don't even have to go to the chemist that often.
And that first album isn't available anymore. We haven't got any copies of that. But
I think
we've lost the master too. I'm not sure where it is. So you might have to ask Marcus Walton about that.
So if anybody's got a copy, it is now actually a rarity.
Yeah, I've got three collectible items.
Yeah, collectible item.
Must be worth a lot.
And the genre was quite different to what the next four albums have had, a different genre. The genre of that one was more sort of quite rocky. Mm-hmm. And what would you call it, Bill?
Kind of folk rock, really.
I've never thought of you guys as folk rock somehow.
It kind of is.
Jazzy blues would be my sort of definition.
Yeah,
oh, see.
Yeah, we made a jump to the left. Yeah, or right, depending which way you think. Yeah.
You can actually hear little threads of it on that very first album. There's a couple of tracks on that that actually show the way to the next way, the where we went after that. Yeah. But funnily enough, they are in the minority. So, you know, if you listen to that first album, you think, oh, the next album will be a kind of a rock and roll album too.
Mm.
But it wasn't. It was like the other two songs on the album.
Well, it's always good to keep the fans on their toes, never knowing what to expect next.
Oh, both of them.
That's right. And the other guys in the band.
You've got
them on their toes.
You've got more than one fan. That's impressive.
I know.
So
might be three.
Tell us a bit about this new album, album number five. What's it called, apart from anything else?
Southern Night Skies is, I think, the working title for this album. And there's a couple of songs on there that allude to the Southern Night Skies. And we've always kind of played around, I guess, a bit with the fact that we're on the southern coast. The Wellington Heads themselves are part of the southern coast. And I guess this song keeps some of that tradition alive.
Mm-hmm. Cool.
The album, we begun this album in November 2012. So it's had a long gestation. And it's all the better for it, I think.
So there's no reason for it not to be very good.
Absolutely no reason at all. And yeah, we've been through various different versions of and changes and what was interesting, we recorded rhythm tracks in 3 days or 2 days of most of the tracks, and then we've just tinkered with stuff and built things up and we've used this studio here to do most of it too.
Mm-hmm.
Which has been a different, it's different from other albums we've done. Yeah. In fact, all the albums we've done have been very different, and again this one that's been quite different. We've used the same engineer as the previous album, Andrew Downs, who've been really enjoyed working with. Yeah.
And just to add a little bit to that, working with the brass guys has been a real pleasure on this album. We decided to take the approach of workshopping the brass parts with them. So we've taken some time up the coast from time to time to workshop with them, and that's been great. Sometimes us singing parts that we think might work, other times just saying, hey guys, it's over to you. What are you going to come up with?
Mm-hmm.
And so we've got Nick Van Dyke and James Tate Jameson have really done a marvellous job, we think, anyway, of putting cream on the cake.
Mm-hmm. Cool.
It's been quite a lot of fun, actually, in that the first album, the Songs from the Living Room, didn't have any brass on at all, and then the next album had a little bit of brass on. Generally, we'd hum an idea and let the brass guys just come up with their own idea. And we discovered that these guys would just about play anything we asked them to. So we got more and more ambitious each album. The brass has gotten more complex and more interesting. Yeah. And this number five has got some of the best brass arrangements on any of our albums. Yeah. They're really good. Nick Van Dyke just really pulled a rabbit out of the hat on a number of those. Took our ideas and that were good ideas, but he made them excellent.
And were they all sort of spontaneous things that they actually just came up with there and then, or were they ultimately?
Yeah, what tends to happen with Wiggin Heads is that we get together, the three of us, and write songs and sort of build them up over time, and then we sort of workshop it with a band, with the rest of the band. That's what's happened with the drummer and with brass players too. We used to do that and sort of build it up like that and start playing it and live, and we'd often be playing stuff for 2 or 3 years before we recorded it.
Mm-hmm.
And this was a wee bit different because when we started recording this album, a lot of that stuff wasn't in place. The brass wasn't in place
mm-hmm.
yet, and still working on ideas with drums. Andrew Richardson's been the drummer for this album.
Oh, okay.
And Andrew was playing with us. He's not playing with us much anymore. We've got a different drummer now. Greg Crayford's drumming for us now. And so it's been an evolve. That's one of the reasons the album's taken a while, because we had a lot of work still to do on it to bring the songs up to their finished product, you know.
Okay. Mm. Well, let's take a short break and actually hear one of the tracks from this album by Wellington Heads.
I woke up this morning, saw you sleeping on the second best pillow. Sun was shining past the blankets. I nailed up last night against the moon. I don't know what it is that draws you to me. I wonder at times just why you care. Of a list of many reasons, and you should change your mind, get out of here. I got 1,157 reasons why you shouldn't be walking. Thank you.
funny things you pick up in your travels. And I've been all over and I have my share. Now the doctor, he says that he can cure some.
That was a cool track from Wellington Head. New album called Southern Night Skies.
Just one sky.
They haven't finished off the artwork yet, so I don't have it in front of me. So let's hope they don't change the title before this programme's broadcast.
Well, it'd be quite good to point out that the album cover artwork actually is a painting by Wellington artist Fergus Collinson, who's generously donated a painting for us to use, because I personally am a major fan of his work, but one thing that he paints better than just about everybody else I know are night skies. Mm-hmm. They have a particular atmosphere about them that's just hard to match, and this album cover will be no exception. It's just wonderful.
Sounds interesting. I'm looking forward to seeing the finished thing then, in that case. And you're having a CD release party at the Bristol on the 17th of March, I believe.
That's what we're working ahead to do, yeah.
have you got it all suitably rehearsed so you know what you're doing?
No.
Okay.
But
well,
positive. But we are playing quite a lot at the moment, so we're not really worried about that. There's songs we're playing all the time. Like our last major gig was at Toast Martinborough last year in November, and we played all the songs on the album pretty much. We've got a little work to do on a couple to make sure we can perform them live really well. Mm-hmm. I mean, we've been playing all these songs live for 2 or 3 years in different formats. So now that should be okay, and we've just got to sort out the booklet's sort of in the process of being done. And Pip Payne, he's doing the artwork for it.
Keeping it all local.
Yeah, absolutely, yeah. Well, he may be living in Vietnam next year anyway, but he's said he'll have something for us on Friday.
Oh, wow.
A sort of a mock-up, you know.
Wow. Mm-hmm.
So, but we've still got, I think Bill's got some more photos you need to send him, I think. And we need to take some photos of some of the members of the band as well to put on it. But we'll get there, and, it doesn't take long. Once you get the masterings process, mm-hmm. will be finished next week, and mm-hmm. and all that sort of stuff out.
Where's that getting done?
The ISRC. Codes and stuff like that all done. And
That's a complicated admin.
Yeah, so you have to get all that done before you can release the album, I guess. You know?
Yeah. And where is it going to be available?
It won't be available. It'll be available from the band, pretty much, from our website.
Mm-hmm.
And it'll
at
be...
At gigs?
At gigs, mostly, yeah. And we'll probably have some copies at Slowboat, definitely.
Mm-hmm.
in Wellington, but pretty much through the website and at gigs. Yeah.
iTunes at all?
Well, we're able to do all that. Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's got all the codes for that. So
yeah.
We just need to sort that out and do it.
Mm-hmm.
Amplifier.
Yeah.
iTunes. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh well, it's all sounding very positive, and you've got some gigs other than Bristol lined up, I believe.
Yeah, just a range of various different gigs. Some private. You know, we're doing a couple of weddings. We're playing Cuba Duper.
Date, Neil?
We're playing Cuba Duper on Sunday the 20th of March.
What time, Neil?
3 p.m. in the afternoon at this stage, at the Bristol stage.
That's more than I know about when I'm playing there.
Yeah, well, yeah, I'm still
sometime on still Saturday, talking, I'm told.
We are still talking with the organiser a wee bit on this one. However, we've got a gig on the 1st of April at Thunderbird Cafe in mm-hmm. Featherston Street on a Friday afternoon, 5:30. That's always a good fun gig.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll be playing as a four-piece at that one. So we play various gigs as four-piece, drums, bass, guitars, and, mm-hmm. or we'll do a six-piece with the brass as well.
Or a four-piece, which was last Sunday.
Yeah. So it's a bit of a mix of
all sorts of
combinations. Depends how much you're getting paid, really, in the end.
It does boil down to that, ultimately. Yeah. Anything less than $25 a head, and it's not worth turning out, really, is it?
That's right.
per the punter or per the band member?
I was thinking you might give the punters a wee bit more just to get them through the door.
Yeah.
And ask them to stay as well. So thank you very much to Wellington Heads, Bill Wood, Jeff Keith. I always try to put that around the other way for some reason. It's your parents' fault. And Neil Warboys.
Yeah, so if you're if you're not doing anything on the 17th of March, please come on down to the Bristol.
Absolutely, because that's the main purpose for this interview.
We can guarantee
time is guaranteed for all.
Indeed.
Yeah. Thank you very much, guys, and we'll play it out with one more track from your new album. Title track from their album Southern Night Sky, but it's going to bring us almost to the end of today's programme, so I've just about got enough time to tell you about some of the gigs that are coming up at the Hotel Bristol, courtesy of Capital Blues. On the 18th of February we've got the David Fian Band. On the 25th we have the Straight Shooters. Now they're actually going to host the jam night as well, so it's a slightly different arrangement to normal, but I'm sure it'll be a great time anyway. On the 3rd of March we've got Ruth Wyand all the way from the United States, a special show for you. And on the 10th, it's myself, Del Thomas, with my band, going in there to play a few songs for you. On the 17th of March, we've got Wellington Heads, the CD release party for that. And on the 24th of March, a very special show, the Chris Kane, all the way from America. You will love this guy. If you love the blues, if you love B.B. King, you will love Chris Kane. And we've got a great band lined up to play with him as well. And then on the 31st of March, we've got the Jam Night, featuring the MC that night will be Dougal Spear. So I hope you can come along to at least one or two of these shows, because we enjoy putting them on for you. And as I say, that brings us almost to the end of today's programme. I hope you've enjoyed it as much as I have. And thanks very much to Access Radio for putting us on air. If you've enjoyed the programme, my name's been Del Thomas. And if you haven't, you can call me whatever you like. And remember, If I don't see you through the week, I'll see you through the window. Thanks very much for listening. Goodbye and God bless. Goodbye.
Star in my night.
That program is brought to you by Wellington Access Radio. Get your voice heard.